When we focus on the ways to reduce America's carbon emissions, we talk a lot about how we generate electricity and the vehicles we use to get around. That's because those two sectors, electricity and transportation, each contribute about a quarter to this country's pollution. And thanks to the rapid growth of renewable energy and more efficient electric cars, those sectors are starting to get much cleaner. But another major source of pollution is what's known as heavy industry. That's making things like cement and steel, and that sector has been much slower to adapt. This week, the Biden administration pledged $6 billion for a series of pilot projects in 20 different states to try and spur a green revolution in those industries. So, will this help move the needle? For that, we are joined by Rebecca Dell. She studies how to clean up heavy industry for the Climate Works Foundation. Rebecca Dell, thank you so much for being here. Energy Secretary Jennifer Granholm says that this is the biggest investment that the United States has ever made in this industry, but it sounds like we haven't really tried to do that much thus far. So I'm just trying to understand, how big an investment is this really?
Yeah, that's a great question. So when we talk about the industrial sector, we're talking about manufacturing, construction, all of the activities that make things as opposed to using energy. And so $6 billion is by a very large margin, the largest investment, not just that America has ever made, but that anybody has ever made in cleaning up the greenhouse gas emissions from this sector. But the manufacturing sector in the United States is like a few trillion dollars a year as a portion of our economy. And so this is a fantastic and inspiring down payment, but obviously this is going to be just a start.
So given that there is this green energy revolution going on right now, why have these slices of the industry been somewhat slow to catch up?
Yeah, so that's a great question. I think one of the reasons why we've seen less progress in the industrial sector is just that people only really started working seriously on it in large numbers, maybe about 5 years ago. People have been working on electric vehicles and renewable electricity since the 90s, or depending on how you count it, maybe even since the 70s. And so we're at an earlier stage here. There's also additional complexity that comes because in industrial activity, often the greenhouse gas emissions don't just come from using energy, they also come from the chemical reactions that are happening to make the materials and the products that you want. And so you have to not just swap out clean energy for dirty energy, but often you have to change the nature of the process that you're using. So this is why, those are some of the reasons why it's been a little bit slower in this sector and why we really need the acceleration that will come from an investment like this one.
So this investment, as I said, is a series of pilot projects that have been awarded to different companies and ventures that applied for these. What kinds of things are getting awarded these grants, and what's it going to look like?
Yeah, so actually one of the things that's so exciting about this project or about this program is that most of the projects are the stage after pilot projects. So most of this are technologies where there's already been a pilot, and this investment is going to take it to actual commercial production scale. And so what we're looking at are things like using hydrogen instead of coal to make steel, using electrified processes to make cement, using alternative types of cement, like, for example, something called limestone and calcined clay cement, LC3, that has inherently lower emissions associated with it. And also there are projects that are using carbon capture and storage. And basically what that means is that you keep using the same process that emits CO2, but instead of letting that CO2 go out into the atmosphere, you capture it and then you pump it into geological formations where it can be stored for a long time.
The Energy Department took great pride that 80% of these projects are going to be ending up in disadvantaged communities that had experienced, quote, years of divestment. What are they referring to there?
Yeah, so I think that's a really exciting part of this. often the areas around industrial development experience a disproportionately high amount of air and water pollution that harms the local population. Also, as many Americans know, we've had significant deindustrialization in many parts of the United States in recent decades. And so for both of those reasons, DOE really wants to make sure that the communities that host these projects are the communities that were impacted by those health harm and pollution and those job losses. And so those communities really benefit from a healthier environment and the tens of thousands of jobs or more that are going to come from these projects.
All right, Rebecca Dell of the Climate Works Foundation, thank you so much for talking with us.
Thank you so much for having me.